welcome back to Waterfall Studios. Today I'm on my own because Dad's working, but I'll be entertaining you today. So today's video will be looking at Matt's new single, The Same Jesus, and we'll be comparing it to his earlier work, From Intimacy, is one of his breakthrough albums. So it'll be fun. Hope you enjoy. So I've recently been re-listening to Intimacy, the whole album. Last night I went through the whole album and listened to all of the songs, praised out to it, and I listened to it along the way to school today. And I also listened to Matt's new live version of The Same Jesus. I've been listening to the song for a few weeks now. I really like it. He released it maybe a month ago, but the live version he recently put out. Already you can see you've got a strong intro, drums in, rhythm guitar in, I think all the instruments in, but we need something like that in our song to get everyone ready and up on their feet. See that nice electric guitar, the sort of melody under the other instruments. Like, doo, 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 doo. Have a listen to it. Still on the road, same Jesus. He's making us new. He's making us new. I know that my demon lives. I know that rhythm guitar is really nice. Have a listen. It's like post-chorus instrumental is really nice. Something like that in our song could be quite cool. So good, building. And it's going to go to the chorus, which is really nice. It's dropped down, just rhythm guitar. It's really nice. Well, overall, that was a really upbeat song. I made some notes yesterday, and I'll share them with you. So, I said, had the book the wrong way. So, I said it's an upbeat tempo. The drums were really cool. You could hear them, just drove the song along. The electric and rhythm guitar I really like. We need to incorporate that in our song. And the bridge. The drop down, and build till the chorus. I will turn my phone off because that's very rude of you. And I said, overall, I think it's really, it's a really upbeat and positive song, and it's a great intro for his new album. Gets everyone excited, and yeah, I'm excited. I'm looking forward to it. I did a few best lyrics too. Still keeping all his promises. At the sound of his cry, the world came alive. He did what he said. He rose from the dead. He's coming back again. So, next, we will look at Intimacy, his groundbreaking breakthrough album. So, see you there. I just love how it's just Matt, his guitar, and God, really. It's just really like personal, it's intimate, but yeah, it's really nice. I think out of the five songs we may plan to do in our EP, I think I should do one just more personal one, me, an acoustic just an acoustic feel song, more just more of a laid back one, which would be quite nice.
Oh Jesus, you're into my soul.
Yeah, so overall that was a really nice just sort of beautiful song, really. Had really nice lyrics and just a soft song. And as I said, I really want to put something like that in our album. Just a real personal song, just being me and God. So I'll start writing. The lyrics I like is, to look on to your beauty, Lord. To know you closer and closer still. My treasure will be your intimacy. So the next song we'll be looking at is Hear the Music of My Heart. Like that, just offbeat. Like that offbeat guitar and strum, which is quite nice. It's almost like jazzy, isn't it? Nothing really like it in worship now, but it's really refreshing, actually. It's nice. I like that melody line. It's nice. Guitar solo, guitar riff in the background, that's quite nice. I definitely need to get some, maybe a guitarist in. I'm not really an electric guitarist myself. I'm more of an acoustic guitarist, so definitely get an electric guitarist in to try and get some riffs in our song. Would be good. We definitely need something like that in our song. Oh, this is a nice drop down bit, nice. So, keep building. That riff's really nice. We definitely need something like this in our song. Like, it's just a breath of fresh air. You don't see this in praise or anything just like this. I like synth pads and all that, but you miss all the acoustics and like just the actual instruments when you put synth as your main thing. That's why I just love Matt Redman's stuff, because he's definitely his original stuff, because it's all acoustic bass and you can just hear all the different electric riffs in the background. It's really nice. It's such a fun song. I wish more praise songs were like this fun. Just all the riffs were just amazing. I did some notes yesterday. It's obviously upbeat. The verses were really cool. Guitar riffs, the offbeat strums in the verses, that was very nice. And the bridge, just that building bridge, was really nice. And the drop back drums and guitar was quite nice. And my favourite lyrics were "You are everything to me" and "Oh how wonderful you are." Repeated, repeated, repeated. But it's really cool. Now, this has been one of my favourite songs for ages. Oh, it's just amazing. It's heart of worship. Like, this was, like, other than 10,000 Reasons, yeah, that was it, 10,000 Reasons, this was the standout song for me, really, that got me hooked on Matt Redman. I heard this song and I was like, oh, goodness, it's just, yeah, Have a listen.
When the music fades.
Just, don't even need an intro, just one chord, so nice. It's just the guitar and Matt, again, just like intimacy. That was so special about his albums, and especially this one. It's just so acoustic centered, and that's what I want for my song.
I'm sorry, Lord, for the thing I've made it, when it's all about.
Just the lines, the piano in the background, just single notes, but it's just really nice, and just the light drums, like, it's all really soft.
You search much deep.
I can just really enjoy acoustic in any song, and just especially, like, it's just a beautiful song. It's just, I love its message, like, to get the heart of worship. Like, you see today, they've got so much perfection, like, or not perfection, so much excellence, that's what people like to call it. And I like excellence. We want to make it the best for God. But sometimes you just need to get just your instrument and God, and just not worry about anything else, and just naturally just praise God for everything he's done. And that's why I just love this song. It's just so stripped back, and yeah, it's really cool.
All about you, Jesus. I'm coming back to the heart.
I like how he's got the two voices. I think it's him singing twice, but he's got him doing one harmony and the other guy doing the other, or him doing another harmony, and that's really nice. It's sort of like a duet between him and God, but yeah, it's nice. That's what we need in our song, or at least one of our songs, just either just playing the chorus chords and just saying whatever comes to our head, because that's the beauty of things. Like, that's the beauty of spontaneous worship. It's just whatever you want to bring to God there. Yeah, it's cool. And the bridge is really nice. That's what I want to bring. I want to bring more than the song. I want to bring more than an album. I want to bring something that glorifies God. That's not just a pop album, a pop EP, a rock album, but it's a worship album. It's a thing that glorifies God, and it's a thing that tells everyone else around me that God is the true God. He is the Alpha and the Omega. He is Yahweh, the living God. And that's what I want. Not just a song, but a worship song. Oh, that was worth it. You've already heard my opinion, but I'll tell you my notes that I've had. So I said it's a stripped back, personal song, soft and acoustic focus, which is really cool. My favourite lyrics were, "Sorry for the thing I've made it, because it's all about you, Jesus." And that sums up what, really, my plans for the songs are. It's all about Jesus, and that's what I want it to be about, really. Yeah. Stop past me. You forgot to tell the audience something very important. Future me will now tell you guys what past me missed. I'll stop. But anyway, I did not realise that Matt actually released another single at the same time as the same Jesus, the live version. But past me just didn't realise. But anyway, it's called We Praise You, and it features Brandon Lake, who is a Bethel worship leader. So I won't listen to it because I've kept you long enough now. But I'll just I made some notes on it, and I'll tell you my notes. So it's a more praisey song, like The Same Jesus, and it has lots of electric guitar in and drums, and it's less acoustic for less acoustic focused, like The Same Jesus was. I think it's just another song to get everyone excited for the new album, and hopefully there will be some worshipy songs that that I said I liked in the new album. And the bridge was quite cool too. Well, I like all Matt's bridges because he does them really well. One of my favourite lyrics was, "Let praise be a weapon that conquers all anxiety." So yeah, I'm really excited for the new album, and I hope you are. Another thing that passed me, forgot to tell you, is the name of the new album, Matt's new album. Oh, I mean, it would be helpful, wouldn't it? It would be called Let There Be Wonder. So that would probably be a name of a new song. I've been really impressed with his new songs, actually. They're a bit less acoustic-driven, but I think there'll be a few more softer, more acoustic-driven songs in his EP. I'm curious to see what the whole EP will sound like. I really like Intimacy, his original stuff. I would like to see how it compares to his new stuff. Obviously, the new song's a bit of a contrast to his older songs, but I think there's still that DNA of Matt in his new songs that I love. So it'll come out on the 31st of January. Let There Be Wonder. Go check out the new singles, The Same Jesus and Your Praise. We Praise You. That was it. I had to look at my phone there. Yeah, go check it out and go check out Intimacy too. Back to you, past me. So, till next time. Bye. God bless.